Welcome to another month with the Canvas Report. I'm Jared.
And I am Shannon.
And we're happy to have you back this month to talk more things Canvas and some of the latest updates that they've put out. So in this video, we're going to look at the new Google Assignments LTI, new analytics, and the content direct share. So Shannon, why don't you tell us more about the Google Assignments LTI?
All right, so this is a really cool new feature. It's been in beta for a while. Now it's available to all users. And eventually, starting in September of 2021, this will be the external Google assignment tool that you use when you're creating assignments. Right now, if you use the external tool in assignments, you will see both the Google Docs Cloud Assignment and Google Assignments LTI. Google Assignments has some really cool new features to it. It has an originality report option. It has a real Google Classroom feel to it. So if you've already used Google Classroom, this will be a pretty easy transition for you. If you have never used Google Classroom, there might be a little bit of a learning curve in how the workflow of how you create assignments and how students turn in assignments. So the good news is, if you are ready to jump into this, it is available to you now. And if you are not ready to jump into this, you can ignore it even for the year and just learn it this summer. Because again, it is we're going to have the current or the older Google Clouds assignment available until September of 2021. So you've got some time to adjust to it. But there are some really cool features, so make sure you check it out. Now, Jared, we have been in school for a few weeks now. Teachers have had students on their Canvas instance a lot. How do they know what their students are doing, especially when they're not doing everything face-to-face?
Yeah, that's a great question, especially where we've got so much remote learning going on and some students are there and some students are not. So in your navigation menu, you can add what's called new analytics. And this will allow the teacher to get a snapshot overview of really everything going on in the course. So there's a few different tabs on there, but one of them allows you to see the assignments, the discussions, and the quizzes, and you can see the average score on each one of those, but you can dial down and look at it individually and see like a specific assignment and how many students have turned it in and what the average score was. And the students that haven't turned it in, you can actually send a message to them directly off that screen. So that's really nice. One of the other options is you can see just the weekly online activity that you have in your course. And you can look at that by student. You can look at it by section. You can look at it overall. So you have a few different ways you can do that. And you can actually have up to three of those combined. So you could look at, like, if you've got period one, period two, and period three, you could compare all those on the same graph and see how everybody's doing at once, which is really nice. And then the final option that you have there is just to look at individual students overall. So it'll pull up a list of every student that you have, and you can see like when they were last on and how much of their work they've turned in on time and how many page views they've had and if they participated or not. But you can also look at that individually as well. So you can look at it overall as well as individually. But I think this is a great way, especially where so much of what we're doing is online right now, and we're not seeing our students every day. Like, this is a great way to help the teacher know exactly what's going on. And it is nice that you can download that as a CSV file if you wanted to, and upload that to your grades or your your computer, and see that in a different format. And Canvas has a lot of help for you that we'll include in our notes as far as how to get started with new analytics. So Shannon, what's our tip for the month?
All right, so this is a feature that's actually been available since January, but there is a good chance that maybe something weird happened in March and you may have missed this, but there is the option now to direct share content that you create. You can direct share pages and quizzes and discussions and even full modules. So when you are looking at either your list of assignments or discussions, If you click on the menu button, you will see that you have a share to button or a share to option and also a copy to option. The share to option means that you can share a full module or just an assignment or whatever to a coworker that you're collaborating with. The copy to means that you can copy something you've created in one course straight over to another course. So it's simplified that process. Even though you've always been able to do those things, this just makes it a little bit easier. So don't forget to click the links below in order to see more information and tutorials on those things we talked about today. So for our Google Assignments LTI, the new analytics features that are available, and then just that quick tip of direct sharing content to other users. You also can check out uen.org/canvas. That's where you're gonna find this video, but you're also gonna find lots of other links and information. So if you need more information about Canvas, and especially Canvas specifically related to how we're using it in Utah, uen.org/canvas is a great place for you to go. So check that out for tutorials and help and videos.
Okay, we'll see you next month.
All right, see you later.